Hey there, sports fans, Ribbo here for Caravel Gaming, and we are having the Battle of Tol Barad right now. So any minion you play gives you a free spell of the equivalent mana cost. And this is my deck. It's very tiny guys, and it's surprisingly effective, really easy to make. So I'm sure you've got a bunch of commons like Abusive Sergeant, Argent Squire. We can go through it here. So there you go, Abusive Sergeant, Squire, Elven Archer, a couple of Leper Gnomes, a couple of Noyotrons, Sergeant Protectors, Direwolf Alphas, Haunted Creepers. They're all commons at the moment. Jeweled Scarab. A couple of rares in there. There is a Knife Juggler. Then back to Loot Hoarder. Manu Addict's the other rare. Ridiculous card. You'll see if it gets going. Nerubian Egg. Shielded Minibot. And a couple of Questing Adventures. So 8 rares. Everything else, common as muck. But wins a whole bunch of games. Loses a few as well, you know. But if you go first, the deck's ridiculous. You just need a tiny bit of luck on the spells, obviously. But you'd think you'd run out of gas quite quickly with a deck like this, but you actually don't. And the reason I went with Paladin was obviously to have a look at Liadrin there. But yeah, this is absolutely fine opening hand. We have bubbles, lots of bubbles.
The light protects me.
Might as well chuck that out there for his first minion. It might be a 2-drop, like a 3-2 or something. And to the face we go.
Put this apple on your head.
I am shocked that it was a knife juggler. I really am. Oh, hey, look at that! I also have knife jugglers. Holy Light's probably not the best spell to get right there. Bit of a rough one, that Holy Light. His deck's pretty much identical to mine. I feel like someone's been watching me play. Well, he's doing pretty well so far. Ooh, a questing adventure, eh?
Give me a quest.
It's not going to be the hardest thing in the world to kill at this moment. However, that's nice. As long as he doesn't get a swipe for free, that'd be annoying.
Give me a quest. Not on my watch. Quest accepted.
Let's go with that. Oh, he's doing the summoning zone. He's so sneaky. Yep, now I considered the summoning zone myself, but I found it a bit slow and laborious, really. But it's pretty cool. I did have it in the other version of my deck before I did this version. Let's go to the face because it's funny.
Reporting quest accepted. Quest accepted.
Why not? Let's just go to his face because I'm gonna make more minions. And one of them's going to say Frostbolt when I play a 2-drop. One of them going to draw a card is going to say Frostbolt. I'm going to go to his face. But let's hope he doesn't have too many holy lights he's drawn.
Put this apple on your head.
Now we just sit here and wait to see whether he can kill us or not. Really, there's nothing else to this part of the game. You just sit here for a minute and a half while they sit there as well, really. Oh, okay, so he's actually got, like, an equality and a consecrate. Pretty sneaky stuff. And a minute and a half digs down. Like I said, it was obviously inequality, and again, just there taking him forever. And of course he gets armor as well, just for additional rubs. I'm really hoping that's explosive trap. It is! Oh, that's so funny! LOL! He was like, I got you with my explosive trap and equality combo! Ah, good times. It's just when you think you've run out of gas, it just goes, no. Of course, there was loads of other two mana spells that would have done it, like Frostbolt. And you can think of all the other burn spells that cost two mana as well. Even something like Unstable Portal would have done it, really. Get you another minion that gets you another spell.
My hammer burns with holy fire.
Yeah, why I keep all of these. There's almost no bad draws with this deck, apart from when you're going second, which sucks. But if anyone's got a slow hand, you just absolutely destroy him. Oops, I've still got this horrible cough. It won't go away.
The light protects me.
Naturalize is actually pretty good. Oh. Let's see if he realises he's about to get destroyed if he doesn't damage that thing. Apparently not. Apparently not.
Give me a quest.
Oh, that's pretty good. You know what? I actually like this play. Yeah, I'll give you two extra cards, and then I'll draw up to the same number of cards as you.
One shot, one kill.
And then I'll just hit you for 13 with this guy on turn 3 with an 8-8 as well and say, go! And now he's thinking, maybe I should have killed that mana addict. Now he's like, yeah, I'm going to do something about this now. Oh, yeah, I just draw a feigned death, I believe I did. I was like, is that a feigned death I see there? I was like, yes it is. How ridiculous. Go? Even if he brawls, I still get 2 4/4s after the brawl, plus whatever survived. I love it, because people are doing these dead slow decks, and you're just absolutely destroying them with just terrible minions. Oh, he's finally realizing, yeah, that mana addict is pretty sick. Yes. Build a faster deck next time, sir. This is stupid. It's absolutely ridiculous, this deck. I mean, a lot of my wins just from me going mana addict and them going, looking at it and going, that does nothing, and me going, actually, hit you for 15? Still doing nothing, sir? No? Okay. Boo mages. So basically every mage ever looks at Flame Waker and goes, this card's incredible. And then you beat them anyway. So we're chucking the knife jugglers back because we want kind of minions with bubbles and jeweled spirits and stuff like that. Now occasionally the Flame Waker still does defeat you, but usually you're too good for it. It all depends on, you know, what free spells you get. Because the Flame Waker should generally only sit around for a turn. Like, you will play some guys out, and one of the cards you get for free will say Frostbolt, or, like, you know, Soulfire or something.
The light protects me.
Do I want to do that this turn? I actually don't, because he's going to be playing his one drop, so I don't want to get his coin or his one drop really from the mind vision. Yeah, they all do this. You all go, spell damage, oh my god, this is incredible. Another Adalaran mage. No, I never placed it there. You saw that. I clearly placed it in the middle of those two there. I'm not happy about that at all. Do I want one of those myself as well?
Should I?
That's nasty. That's really nasty. I'm not happy. He's got overload now, hasn't he? No. It's going to be completely free, isn't it, that? Yes, we chuck this there, then. Placement bug. Yes, he does have overload. Oh, I guess I'll throw some of these guys down. Call pet. That's a nice pet.
Weapons ready. I fight.
And in case he has got a flame waker, and he just goes, "Ha ha, flame waker!" Just throw that snipe down there.
Give me a quest.
Oh no! I'm so sorry. You had plans for that questing adventurer, and now it's dead.
Well played.
Yep, that's ruined his turn completely. So just trying to make it a little bit more survivable, the Mana Addict, since it's going to win me the game.
I enjoy raiding.
Oh, and he realizes how ridiculous it is. Maybe I'll have two of those. Maybe I will.
Put this apple on your head. You win.
Yes. You suddenly realized I was going to run my 1/1s into that thing and then trigger off all the extra spiders and go shoot everything and make a bunch more guys. Like I said, the deck's stupid because everyone builds slower decks than the decks I build.
Leandrin versus Jaina.
And you just have so much stuff going on and so many things to do.
My heart burns with holy fire.
So I'm gonna chuck Knife Juggler away. I do want a one drop. There you go, better than nothing. Ooh, and that's one of the best one casting cost spells in this format, Mortal Coil.
I'll give it a shot.
All mana worms must die. This Dark Iron Skulker is going to be utterly stupid.
What lurks in the depths?
Ooh, 10 power on the board, and you can't touch him. He says. This could be a problem. Oh, well, there's the mana addict.
Put this apple on your head.
That was quite nice, wasn't it?
I can taste the mana.
So yeah, as it turns out, you don't actually. You don't have to actually have expensive cards and to have tons of stuff going on. Because this guy's about to get destroyed unless he can deal with all of these things. Especially that mana addict.
Put this apple on your head.
No! Look what he got! How rude! Got to be an explosive trap in there, right? So I guess we run this guy into this. So sneaky with his snake traps. And in least surprising explosive trap ever. I wish I had Commanding Shout. That would have been pretty good against Explosive Trap.
Mind if I roll knee?
But he's still on 13. We've got plenty of things going on over our side of the board. Doesn't help him as much as he thinks, because of course I get to play these down and get more free spells. Why did he do that? Why? Everything goes away. And he's like, yes.
mortal need.
Shields up. Red alert.
And we were back where we were at the start of last turn. Before he vanished. And my guys are a little bit smaller now. Ooh, resurrect, eh? Another call pet.
One shot, one kill.
What lurks in the depths?
Hey, give me that!
You killed my guy, how could you? So yeah, you think having a slower deck helps, but it doesn't really. Nice flame strike, bro. Lots of guys still. He's there going, ha! I can flame strike! But this deck's so stupid that it doesn't care. So yeah, I could have played that better, but I don't care because you're just chucking stuff. You're just chucking stuff at them and seeing what sticks. And if you screw up, that's fine. Just concede and play another game. But this entire mana base is 2 mana. And yet, turn 9, I'm still using up all my mana every turn, doing things.
My hammer burns with holy fire.
Yes, I will keep all of those cards going second. The deck, you think, is complete garbage. But it turns out it's pretty ridiculous. Boo! We don't like that card coming down turn 1. And now we do have a commanding shout. He's pretty nifty. So this has always been a sick play where you go turn 1 shielded mini bot and then like Argent Protector turn 2. Do we really want the overload one? I don't think we do. I don't think we want the overload one yet.
You will regret this.
That's something worth crackling. If you ever wanted to deal 6 damage to something, that would be it. That's fine, because like my guys are trading off with your guys.
The light protects me.
Ooh, a free wrath, you say? Don't mind if I do.
This is my responsibility.
So Ribbo got really fast decks. Unfortunately, he's going first, so he gets to do all the ridiculous stuff. Egg's nice, we like that. I think my questing adventure is going to come down in 2 turns. Well, if I play it now, he does have to kill it, which buys me a bit of time. Oh, hey, look, it's another Dark Iron Dwarf. So we're still in this, depending on whether he got double swipe. Because it happens. Trust me, it happens. Or double power overwhelming. Also works. And a swipe. And a fireball. There you go. So, we lost the coin toss at the start, and we lost because of it. And there's nothing you can do about that. Again, it's like you really want to go first in this format. Or you don't mind going second if your opponent's got a slow hand, because then you destroy him. But if your opponent's actually realised and is doing much the same stuff as you, then it's just whoever goes first really and gets that bit of luck with the spells.
My hammer burns with holy fire.
Well, we've got the egg sergeant combo. So I think we go with that. If we get really lucky, we draw another one drop. We don't draw another one drop. Now we kind of sit here while he thinks about what to do turn one. Come on! Haven't got all day. It's turn one. It's hard work for people to think of stuff like that. That went well. I'm worried what he mind fissioned off me. I'm hoping it's an abusive sergeant, and not an egg.
Do you like to play with fire?
Might as well make your free spell, dude, to pop my bubble. Oh. Ooh, Power of the Wild. So, like I said, you go first. You build up a nice little board, and some really cool things start to happen.
Give me a quest. Get in there and fight, maggot.
Yeah, let's do it this way. Go.
Give me a quest.
I believe you've lost. He's so sneaky. Unfortunately, I have polymorph boar. He's going to be so sad.
One shot, one kill.
Quest accepted.
Go. Dark Trap's never going to do anything. He's never going to use his hero ability, but Avenge definitely might see a bit of play. Oh, he's also playing Eggs. Might be a bit late for him, however.
The light protects me.
We appear to have a very similar deck. More guys.
Reporting for duty.
Weapon ready.
Go. Good old eye for an eye there. It appears we have exactly the same deck. Like, he's also playing Wolves. I think it's because I've been absolutely smashing people in the face for the past few hours with this deck. The people I've been playing against, I'm sure I've played against him before, have just gone, you know what? I need to build that deck. Created by Thoughtsteel. Just like looking in the mirror. It's just like looking in the mirror. You gonna give it taunt as well? You do realise you're on 5, right? And okay. Egg sprouts legs and beats you up. It's like little legs come out of the egg and it just walks over. Gosh. Headbutts him. Because that's all he's got. So yeah, this deck's really fun. And super cheap. Super cheap. Only 8 rares. Everything else common. And you don't have to have this particular like bunch of cards. There's a few cards which are absolutely critical to the deck, but you know, there's probably better cards than some of the ones I'm picking. I'm obviously trying to draw an egg there or something. Or,
is someone injured?
Oh! Here we go. I will curse you! Actually, no. I wanted that to be a leper gnome. Curse you again! He's pretty sneaky, cursive for a fireman at the start of the game. Blessing of Wisdom seems pretty good as well.
What a rush.
And take half your life off you in one turn. So yeah, don't build slow decks. He needs a swipe. Did he get a swipe? No! My mana addict! No! I bet he's feeling all proud of himself now. Ooh. Save that one for later. He finally decides to get it out of his hand. He's like, you know what? I should probably get rid of that. Yes, yes you should. Tempted just to go to the face at this point.
The dancing master.
Okay, that actually changes things a little bit there.
Get
So again, he's in that same situation where that man radic's about to kill him. No! I bet he got an equality as well for two mana. Yeah, we just do it that way, really. Oh, and that's game.
Not on my watch.
Can't even play Deadly Shot because he doesn't have a minion. How annoying is that, huh? Knife juggler, ping, 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 ping.
Let me change your mind.
He's taking my guy. How rude. And a free avenging wrath as well. That's pretty sick. Gotta say, that is pretty sick. Ooh, a nice flame cannon. Hobgoblin. Come here, worthless imps. Look at him on four life, holding on with the skin of his teeth. Worthless imps are going to get the hobgoblin treatment. And then I draw power overwhelming anyway. Axes for you. Have another curse, sir. Bash! You just don't need things that cost more than two mana. Utterly unnecessary. So I reckon you'll throw this deck or something very similar to it quite quickly, and you got a few days to play before it goes away. We'll play one more, why not? I'm in the mood. I had to play a few more just to prove to you it's not some fluke, and it is actually ridiculously fast format. Boo, mages, pinging my guys. But we've got the egg and the scarab, which are both pretty crucial. And the creeper as well. Wow, this is stupid. Well, he kept at least one of his cards there, so it's probably a mana worm. Shock horror, it's a mana worm. Who would have guessed? Since I've got Elven Archer in hand, yeah, I'll deal it 4 damage. And we lead out with the egg, because he's not going to play a spell on it. Oh!
One shot, one kill.
Seemed pretty good. You know, it recovers from, like, ridiculous... Like, loads of people do this mana worm thing. It just gets really fat. And then you make something crap, and the free card you get deals with the mana worm. You're like, oh, that was nice. Like, everyone picks mage because of mana worm and flame waker.
I wonder.
Don't worry, loves. The cavalry's here.
Let me guess, he runs it into my 4-2 because he's got explosive shot. I guess he doesn't. Oh, the hobgoblin again. More fun times with hobgoblins. Look at this. I remember.
Someday I'll be just like you.
Forked lightning goes. That's nice, dear. Overload 2.
I'll give it a shot.
I think I'd just sit on that, really. And there it is. Right on cue. Like, this is why you save your dark bombs. It's a buff frog.
Mind if I roll need?
Frog's been working out. They all do this, and they think, oh, I'm so incredible, I'm surely the first person to ever think of this combo. And then you're like, don't care. Really don't care.
Not on my watch.
Nice. But it's annoying because he got the divine to favour to fill his hand back up. Like, if he didn't have that, he'd be on 2 cards now and this game would be over. So, that sucked. And that's kind of the RNG of this, really. Thank you. Ooh, ancestral knowledge.
I can taste the mana.
Mind if I roll need?
It's like, what's going on here? We'll save that ancestral knowledge for next turn. We've got a ridiculous combo there with the Mana Addict and the Wind Fury. Come on, you still got 3 mana. That's it, keep playing them cards. Eye for an eye? No! So funny. Of course it's eye for an eye. I'm thinking noble sacrifice, you know, take the 2 damage, stuff like that. Of course it's an eye for an eye. But you can see, like, out of nowhere... Oh! Eat it! Have some of that! Dart trap! Whoop whoop! Oh, he did not see that one coming. He's gonna be so mad over that! Oh, that was hilarious! What a finish! I love the way he went, well played as well. Well played! Kill you? Oh, that's nasty. Did he have a gnome on the board that he could have just run into something and killed me with that? Am I imagining that? It was a loot hoard, wasn't it? Yeah, I was thinking it was a leper gnome. Well played. Yeah, well played. So sick. I've got to play another one. Like, this deck is legitimately fun. Like, I almost had him as well. That's the best thing about the deck right there. Yeah, tracking's such a nice one drop. Oh! Oh, that's pretty sick. That's pretty sick, isn't it? That cold blood on this guy next turn. Oh! Oh! Suit you. Or even on the egg in a couple of turns' time. And this guy's going... This guy's also done a fast deck! It's like I'm just staring back at the same deck. It really is. Oh, there's Curse of Rafam again. Oh, I love this card so much. So, saving the cold blood for the egg.
shot, one kill. I fight.
Burn. Norm 15. Go. He's there going, I didn't expect that. All that damage out of nowhere. What's going on?
Ready to ride.
The hunter's there going, I'm meant to be the aggro player. Yeah, I'll shoot you as well. And then when this guy pops out.
I don't have enough mana.
Hey, catch!
I'll give it a shot.
I fight.
Burn.
Put you to two. So sick. So sick. It's just like the worst minions you've ever seen. Beating the crap out of people.
Well fought. I can see.
Yarp. I've got time for one more. So I've only lost one so far. It's like 43 wins. Only, yeah, I've lost one and drawn one. Just do it. Just build this deck. And laugh at all these mages.
My hammer burns with holy fire.
I'll keep all those. They seem absolutely fine. Like, the Elven Archers are in there, because lots of people make, like, 2-1s for one mana as well, so it's just there to go, ping, that guy.
Someone injured?
Oh, so annoying. Ooh. Ooh.
One shot.
Well, it turns out you don't care. You don't care about that annoying 1-3 on turn 1. Like, and this is your late game card, Jewel Scarab. That's actually pretty good.
Red alert. I'll give it a shot.
And it's a great card to put Death Rattle on. It's like, yeah, do I want a guy to come back with another bubble on him? Yeah, I do. But a lot of people just overthink things. It's like, you know, this is all about getting in lots of wins, so it doesn't really matter if you make mistakes, just play all your cards and get on with the next game. I could have put it on this. Made it a 3-3 with taunt. Ooh, it's a sneaky explosive sheep. Wow, and picked up a sap as well. Look at him go. Why are you playing things? You just put an explosive sheep down. Pink Master? Seems a bit stupid, doesn't it? But stupid is fun. Right? I'm just going to hopefully try and kill all of his guys and then turn one of my crappy 1-1s into a 5-5.
Is someone injured?
Get in there and fight, maggot!
Well played.
Cold blood, you say? You get a ridiculously large number of secrets.
We hunger for vengeance.
How many fingers do you see?
Ooh. Billy bonus when you get the unstable portals. That's a nice minion to get out there. I'm going to save that one for later.
Weapons ready.
So we've got the freezing trap. So I don't really care about his one guy, as long as I've got this freezing trap. And he now has a flame strike. Or a sprint. He got a sprint.
battle!
I fight. I can taste the mana!
Is too full.
Another explosive sheep. You're all excited for what he's going to do now? And back you go. Whoop, 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 whoop.
Welcome to the exhibit.
So I just swipe face here, and everything dies on his side of the board. Well, I can keep this alive by
I fight.
By doing that.
Give me a quest.
Put the apple on your head.
Oh, that does a job. Yeah, I'll just take Savage Roar. Thank you very much. And he's there with his, like, 10 cards in hand, going, I've got all these cards! Yeah, but you've took 30 damage, sir. You are dead. Anyway, guys, like, look at that. Look at the mana cost there. 2 cards cost 3 mana. The rest of the deck, 1 and 2. And you're just doing stuff all the time, going, oh my god, this is so stupid! Give it a try. It's super easy to build, and ridiculous lot of fun, and you know it's a nice way of getting 100 gold for the day in no time at all. Anyway, you know, check it out. You've only got a few days, and you know, let me know if there's any cards you would have put in a bit differently, because like I said, I just chucked this together from stuff and went, you know what, these all work. Meh. Let us know what you think, and until next time, ta-da.